Ladies and gentlemen, over the last decade, we have seen the progression of startups in India. It started with plain vanilla e-commerce, selling clothes and electronics, and has since diversified into a number of different hyphen techs. So there is fintech, there is health tech, there is edutech, and each of these has a homegrown unicorn or a near billion dollar player based in India itself. Now, however, there is a segment that is trying to make a foray into as large an industry as you can hope for in India. Agri-tech is on the rise. Today we are joined by a very special guest. Gramophone CEO and co-founder Tausif Khan is with us, and he's going to be telling us a little bit more about all the services that Gramophone, his company, offers to India's farmers. Before I hand it over to him and I ask him to tell us what are the things that Gramophone does, I would just like to emphasize that while we have heard in the past about a lot of startups being based in Bangalore, Hyderabad, Gurgaon, Noida, Mumbai, Gramophone is actually based in the very heart of India, in Indore. So it's taking its services right to the very people who require them the most. Tausif, thank you so much for joining us on Republic. We hope you're having a great day. And I would like to start by asking you to tell us exactly what Gramophone does and what are the suite of services that it supplies and for whom.
Hi, thanks for having me here. So I'll just quickly start with what Gramophone does. We our core like philosophy is to work with farmers directly, and we help them earn more from the land that they have. So in that process, what we do is that we provide them all kind of solutions to grow a crop, which is technology led, and we monitor their entire like practices are right from sowing till harvest. And very recently, we have also started enabling them to sell through the platform, connecting them for the market linkages. So it provides the full stack like support to the farmers, which guides him right from sowing to harvest. And then we also like enable them to basically buy inputs which are used to grow the crop, and then finally connecting them to the right buyers on a single like platform. So it becomes an end-to-end like support for the farmers.
Okay, so if I'm to break it down, and I've been doing some reading, you one offer a set of intelligence services where you advise farmers on the different agriculture related issues that are out there, such as weather, such as seed, such as pests, such as which crops.
Yes.
You also have a model where you have commercial transactions ongoing, which means that you also partake in the buying and selling of agricultural inputs. And lastly, you just spoke about a platform that you have recently launched to enable farmers to sell their produce on the platform itself. Can you sort of break down each of these three, the intelligence services, the commercial aspect, and also your new platform where farmers are even selling on their own?
Sure, I'll like delve a little deeper into it. So in the entire like supply chain for farmers, so there are different like manufacturers of products to them, which is basically seed manufacturer, then there is a crop protection manufacturer, and other like similar products. So if you look at healthcare in India, then the doctor to patient like ratio is also very skewed. But compare the same in agriculture actually. The problems for farmers are year on year increasing in terms of different kinds of pest and disease problems coming in. Then in terms of spurious products, which is there in the market. So in totality, what is happening is that our productivity levels are almost like half of the global like average in most of the commodities. And then the need of like food is growing year on year. Quality also needs to be maintained. So what we do is that we act as a doctor to the farmer, wherein we guide them across the cropping cycle in terms of the various few data points. What we are able to build is that a farm management solution, which is agronomy intelligence led, and that in turns with certain data points like his sowing dates, his crop which he is doing, the location of that particular area, we are able to actually like derive what is the right practice for that. And then with automated like notifications, SMSs, IVRs, based on various like types of farmers, whether they have a smartphone or not, whether he has just a feature phone, we are remotely able to guide them in this cycle. And what happens with this guidance is that the end outcome is like a medicine for the farmer. Just like if you have fever, then there is maybe paracetamol or with certain antibiotics which will be needed. Similarly, at different stages of the crop, he needs different products to cure this problem, to manage his pest and disease problems, to basically manage nutrition, the soil. So it becomes automated entirely on the platform. And then the second part where we basically monetize the farmer is by selling these inputs. So the derivative of the our advice is a combination of products to the farmer, which will be different at each stage of a crop. And that product is sold through a platform. He buys either through the application or through giving a call if he doesn't have a smartphone. And then we have also empowered like last mile guys who are doing farming. So these are people who could be a BSc agriculture or somebody who has his 12th pass and has been doing agriculture for quite some time. We have a different application called as Gram Connect application. Farmers, so these people can actually like enroll on that, become our partner and provide an assisted commerce and then farm management to be very close to the farmers as well. So this is the way in which we basically give advice, be it anybody who has a feature phone or a smartphone. And then finally, like this enables us to sell them inputs, which is delivered at the last mile. And it is a big problem, both in terms of the remoteness of like agriculture. Every commerce historically has been like done or companies are built in urban areas. So this is a unique problem where you even like deal with logistics, how you basically deliver at the last mile. So your supply chain is very different. And but in terms of problems that people are getting benefits to the tune of their cost of cultivation reduces by 10 to 15%. And we have seen that historically happening for last like 5-4 years of our operations. And then the quality of output is better. And the overall quantity that they get from that is also like better. So this in totality, actually, like if somebody is coming on the platform and following all the practices, he benefits by at least 50% in the overall like income that he was getting earlier. And then further down the line, what we have also done over here is that the knowledge that is being imparted through the farm management solution, we have started monetizing that in by giving them premium services where he can actually like get customized soil based recommendations also. So he can register his farm, geotag it, geofence it, and then the customization starts from there, that we talk about the plot level of the farmer. And this is very scalable, that earlier these kind of solutions were only available for enterprises. And those enterprises were managing the farmers on their platform. But now we have built it in a way that at scale, even a 2-acre farmer can actually use it on his smartphone. And if he even doesn't have a smartphone, then he can just give us a call and we'll do it in an assisted way. So that way, I think it encompasses a very India-specific problem, and the solution has been made in a very India-specific way. So I think, yes, that's pretty much about it. And I think what also is happening, that in this entire process, what we get to know is that where his land is, what is the total output that would come out on day one. So a demand and supply match, we have been trying to, we had envisaged on day one that this is something that would happen. But on year 5, we are entering our 5th year very soon. So now we have been able to actually bring the traders, processors also on the same platform. And as we know that when his harvest will come out, so we start pushing out where he can actually like sell. And there is by his geo-based location, we are able to give him cost of logistics, and then price benefits that he might get. So it's an evolving platform on the output side right now, but we are getting like very early success over there, that it is scaled almost like 2x, 3x every month.
Right. No doubt it's a very challenging area in which to launch this kind of service, but one of course that has enormous potential. I've read on your site itself that you say that 60% of India's employment is in the agriculture industry, but only 17% of the GDP. There was something very interesting that you said. You equated gramophone to a sort of doctor for farmers, and gramophone, essentially its intelligence services, is sort of like a prescription for the farmers. I also read how you call gramophone a personal assistant for farmers. So undoubtedly, these are a lot of services that for the first time people are looking to provide to India's agrarians in a concerted and modern sort of manner. But it's not easy. There is a new product or sort of term that you have mentioned. You talk about agronomy, agricultural economy, I'm guessing. Could you tell us a little bit more about that, and what are the different services, and what is the kind of knowledge that you provide to farmers under this agronomy header?
Sure. So basically, if I have to define agronomy, is actually any science of agriculture. So historically, if we have seen that who are the people who provide advice to the farmer? It is either the peers, and then the knowledge which is basically gained by the companies who are selling products to the farmer. So once you are selling products to a farmer, you are a manufacturer, then the end goal is actually to sell those products. Nobody is bundling both services and like product sale. So this platform becomes a neutral kind of a platform on which he gets both the parts, where he's management. It's more like raising a child. Growing a crop is more like raising a child, where there will be different challenges at each stages of the growth of a child. So therefore, you have to manage it in that way. And right nutrition, right like seeds, right crop protection, and then selling of that like crop is also like that big a challenge. So from an agronomy perspective, what I mean by is that we everything that we do, we built it in a way that if there is a additional cost that is coming to a farmer, then there should be an additional benefit, basically the marginal benefit and marginal cost, like a philosophy where if 500 rupees extra he is spending, so is he getting like 400 rupees or 5000 rupees extra out of it? So that way, what we have done is that we are trying to basically convert his farming into more like a business, where he can actually look at the cost of cultivation, inputs, and break it down the inputs into small pieces and parcels, that what is going into the crop, and then finally what is coming out of that. So bringing everything together on a single platform and giving that to a farmer in the language which is he is like understanding. So this is a second level of challenge which the agriculture kind of startups basically face with, that every 100 kilometers overall like dynamics change. So you have to build your platform to be ready for all those things. Therefore, I think the entire mapping the entire like landscape of India, that different agroclimatic zones are there. Each agroclimatic zone has its own like weather and soil type, and the different crops would grow over there. So once you bring all these things together on a single platform, then doing that at a scale becomes easier. And for the farmer, everything becomes that what is the money and labor I'm putting inside, what is the output I'm getting outside. So bringing, this is what we call it in what you were referring as agriculture economy, how we can convert it more data-based, more end outcome-based, and then mapping both demand and supply together. So a platform like this, we feel that in the next few years, maybe like 3 years, 5 years down the line, all these things will become something which is basically talk of the town in terms of anybody, a farmer who has smartphone will be doing it like this. I hope I answered your question.
I actually have a follow-up with regards to that. Accessibility is essential. Because you are dealing with a rural economy, they are maybe not as exposed to a lot of digital services as maybe people are in cities. So Brass Tacks, how do you reach out to farmers? You have spoken about different languages. What kind of language support do you provide? And if I am a farmer and if I want to join gramophone services, what do I need to do?
So I think on this like part, accessibility, like if I talk about the journey, we started in 2016. So in 2016, with a three-member team overall, one thing was very clear, that smartphone penetration at that point of time was not that great. So it was a simple like solution on which if somebody has a feature phone, he can just give a missed call on a toll-free number. And we had internally like built a product which is called as Gram Salah. What it does is that as the farmer gives the call, his certain basic data points that where he's from, what the, are the crops that he is growing, and at what stage the crop is right now. We take this and then we have built internal like a platform which basically builds the entire profile of the farmer. So in a way, with a smartphone, he can now do it today, 3 years, 4 years down the line. He can do the same thing over his phone in itself. So that penetration of smartphone has helped a lot, where I would say that today, the same thing that he was doing over a call, he's doing it on his smartphone and it is available to him. And reaching out to the farmer, I think today is not that difficult, again, because of the internet penetration. So in certain like areas where the penetration is much better or the states which are a little like well off there, I think we are seeing a very good adoption of our application. We have Hindi as one of the language, Marathi as another like language. So entire North Indian belt we pretty much like cover, and we've seen like farmers coming from Assam and using the application for managing their farm. And then in future, what where we are heading is that the architecture is like built in a way that we can launch any number of languages, either Indian or outside India as well. The platform is ready for that. So we are launching like Gujarati, Tamil, Telugu, and all the other languages in next like few months period of time, that the information would be converted in those languages and those farmers can also start like using it. And I think WhatsApp is a very good disseminator of these things, where you can actually like reach out to not many farmers. Facebook, YouTube. So we have seen like farmers using these channels a lot in rural areas. And lastly, I think it's a mix of both digital and offline like channels. Offline, what I mean by that, I was talking earlier about our Gram Connect application, which is used by any micro entrepreneur who has basic agriculture knowledge. He can use that application and manage like a set of 100, 200, 300 farmers himself, and then earn from that like our platform. So that is something which we launched last year during COVID times. So which has like given us the remote assistance as capability as well.
All right, Tausif, thank you so much for telling us that. My second to last line of questioning to you would be on your uptake and your last year. Obviously, we've been in a lockdown. We are in the kind of position where many people say that we should go into lockdown again. How has 2020 been, and how have the first few months of 2021 been? You have actually raised funding during that period. Please tell us a little bit more.
Sure. So I think 2020 post like lockdown, I think it was pretty difficult for any like small business or startups. But what happened at that point of time was that this agriculture like comes up under special essential service. It was a very small period of time when the services like went off. But in within 15-20 days, we started like working. And at that point of time, I think we were at the harvest stage, and then certain like sowing was happening. So there was a huge like requirement of seeds and other products which farmers were frantically like calling. So we started our like delivery network, and then we basically converted. A lot of things were happening, like the call center was being run from the office of, and we made it like remote. Everybody who was there working, they went to their villages. And then from there, they started like calling, and we got a very good like demand, and there was a huge like digital shift. So like earlier, there were 3-4% of farmers who were actually like transacting on the application. At the and this was the case like pre-COVID, but now I think that number has changed to around 25%, and we have not like done anything new on that. It's just naturally that has happened. So this year we expect that the farmers who were coming through, I would say the call center, it would go to around 40-50%. So that's the kind of change that has happened, that people have started adopting this. They had like applications on them, but usage has increased and transactions have started like coming in, which is a huge like shift from pre-COVID level. And in terms of, I think the last year was tough for everybody, but given the performance, both our like economics work was getting like better. So we raised like round and closed it in December last year. And we, like in the COVID times in itself, like I mentioned earlier, that we started the outdoor business as well, which has been scaling from zero to significant like volume just 4 or 5 months.
All right, great. My last line of questioning to you would be about your team. Tausif, now you, if I'm not mistaken, are an IIT, IIM alumnus. A number of people in your core team are also the same. Can you tell us a little bit more about the people behind Gramophone, where you come from, how it was starting out, and what you plan to do in the future?
So we belong to UP, actually, all four of us. So this was started by four of us. Nishant, who happens to be my batchmate from both IIT and IIM Ahmedabad. And Harshit, he also is a batchmate from IIMA. Ashish, who basically takes care of technology, he is my school friend and IIT Madras graduate. So he sits out of actually Bangalore, our technology team sits out of Bangalore right now. Overall, I think from a team point of view, what happened is that we started doing all these things, and over the last like 2-3 years period of time, we have added like quite good people in the entire time. Like agronomy is led by somebody who has 30 years of experience, so it's a very young team. And then wherever you need like gray hairs where experience like matters, we have people like that also in the like, in the team. And last thing, I think in terms of output, we have added like significant experience like people in the team who come with more than 10-15 years of experience who are there. So that way, the team has been primarily somebody who has involved in agriculture. So we all are actually agriculture engineers. So, and we have been associated with agriculture for the last like 15 years. Now, while starting up happened in 2016. And then I was also like investor in one of the VC funds and investing in agriculture like sector from 2014 to 16. So that gave a lot of like understanding of what is happening and what the future will entail. If I talk about like where we are headed, I think right now we are at a juncture where we have everything in place, and we would see that rapid scale up across multiple states. And from a technology standpoint of view, we would be adding like and enhancing our capabilities around farm management and taking it to more like number of farmers. More data and AI-led solutions would be built for the farmers, where we are actually enabling them to produce more from the same land and improving their economics much better. So I think that's pretty much, I would say, is something that you can keep on doing for the next like 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, and the problems would still be there. So it's a large like problem where we are doing our role to provide some kind of impact on the lives of farmers.
Right. Thank you so much, Tausif, for telling us that. That was really enriching in terms of knowing what the agricultural economy of India can look at in the future. We know for the longest time, maybe going back centuries, perhaps millennia, the farmers of the country have been dependent on various things that are completely out of their control, whether it be the rain gods, whether it be prices, whether it be middlemen, demand, supply. All of that has been taken away from them. It's only now we see it politically, and more importantly, we see it economically, where there are young entrepreneurs who are studying in the topmost institutions in the country, who are moving back to places that are essentially surrounded by rural economy and trying to give back. There is a lot of effort that is required for this. There is a lot of formulation. It's not always easy. It sometimes takes years to have an uptake. It takes years to refine a product. But what these end up doing is very often they end up making the farmer self-sufficient. It starts off small. It could just be with one aspect of farming, such as selecting the right kind of crops to grow, getting your soil health card, getting the right kind of pesticides. But in a larger sense, it also introduces these farmers to the different tools that are out there that many of them may not have any knowledge about. So that is how a company like Gramophone is helping India along on its road to Atmanirbharta. We wish them all the best. Tausif, thank you so much for speaking to us today. It was a pleasure having you. And thank you to you too, everybody.
Same here. Thanks a lot for it.
Ladies and gentlemen, over the past few weeks, if you've been with us, we have taken you through a number of industries in India that are burgeoning, that are developing, that are using the advances in technology and the digital proliferation that has been accorded to them over these last two decades to expand into new horizons, whether it be health tech, agri tech, fintech. We have encountered a number of companies that are trying to look at an individual's problems and individual's needs and what that person requires to make them self-sufficient. It is indeed a road to Atmanirbharta that we are on. We are not very far along yet. We have miles to go before we finish, and we'll be bringing you a lot more of these very exciting startups on Republic as we go along. Thank you so much and keep tuning in.